Deputy Adams.
Would the Taoiseach agree that the IMF statement yesterday is proof that the IMF-EU deal is a disaster for Ireland? The figures, as revealed yesterday, that this deal is based on are false, and the deal and the international lending agreements which underpin it are good for the big bankers, are good for their bondholders, and are very, very bad for Irish taxpayers. And yet, Taoiseach, at every turn, your government recommits to this deal, and even worse than that, bad enough Fine Gael, but Labour and the Labour leadership recommit at every single turn. And we have Labour ministers out briefing on more austerity policies, more cuts, more pressure on working people, on public servants and on the unemployed. Shaw, Parchy, James, Connolly, Maya. So, Taoiseach, would you not make different political choices? Paying people's money into the banks means less money for growth, it means no money for jobs, it means no money for frontline services or for those who depend on them. It means no ability to pay back the burden of the banking debt. August, it's far cleistahu. Ta sogat nak fejer and do a cur in a gyal ak shal. Taoiseach, citizens elected you for change. But ni lean ahru are beyond. There's no change in the people's pockets and no change between your government's policy and the policy of the last government. So would you now accept, Taoiseach, that the debt placed on this state by the last government, by the EU and IMF deal, is unsustainable and that you, as our representative, need to call a halt to it?
Taoiseach?
Well, I do note in the past eight to nine days that the response internationally has been very positive in respect of the decisive decisions taken by the government. The IMF themselves have recognised the validity of the government's call for a reduction in the interest rates, which would be important, but which is only part of the evolution of discussions that are taking place here. And when you consider that international banks, international commentators, the European Union, the European Commission and the IMF themselves have recognised the fundamental importance of the decision taking about the banking sector by the government, that's a start. It's only the first step in a long process. Now, I'd also point out to you that in respect of what we have to do here ourselves, the government only yesterday agreed on a comprehensive analysis by every minister in this government as to how money is spent, the value for that money, how effective it's actually dealing with the problems that it's supposed to deal with, so that there's a proper process in respect of the preparations for the budget for 2012 in place here, and that you don't find ourselves in a position where ministers, for time immemorial, ended up at the end of November not knowing what sort of cut was going to apply or how whether any value had been achieved for money. I think that this is a serious change in the way we look at the expenditure of taxpayers' money in this country here. The IMF made it clear to both parties in government when the IMF met with them before Christmas that it would be entirely in order to transpose sections or sectors of the IMF EU programme one with another, provided that there were compensatory amounts produced and clarified. The two ministers for finance will be meeting with the Troika today. I think that's going on as we speak. And from that point of view, what we want to do is not only be having to focus on the issue of cuts, but also to focus on the issue of growth and stimulus in our own economy to provide some certainty and confidence for people who want to get back to work and who want to hire new workers and get into a position where we can grow our economy. And as you know, there have been some public comment about the contents of the government's jobs initiative, which will be published in the next few weeks.
Thank you, Taoiseach. Deputy Adams.
Well, Taoiseach, the IMF halved the growth prediction to 0.5%. It's reckoned that there will be a shortfall of $1 billion in the government's exchequer finances. You talk about a jobs budget. Are you going to bring in more cuts? You know, you've given away the National Pension Reserve Fund to the big banks. We propose that that should be used for job stimulus package. Why on earth? You're very, very clear about robbing the poor, about universal social charges, about all of that. But why can't you?
Can we have some order, please?
Why can't you consider, Taoiseach?
Deputy Adams, please. Deputy Adams. Deputy Adams, please.
Taoiseach, why can't you consider a third tax bond? Why can't you consider exploiting natural resources in the common good, including offshore oil and gas resources? Why can't you tell the IMF and the EU that we want to run our own affairs? We can't always blame Fianna Fáil for what Fine Gael and Labour are doing. They have their own responsibility. But you and I are repeating every mistake that they made.
Taoiseach? I think it's important to point out, Deputy, that what we're talking about is a jobs initiative, not a jobs budget. Budgets indicate ranges of tax increases or tax changes and so on. This is a jobs initiative which has been well flagged before the general election, which is part of the government's programme for government to stimulate the indigenous economy, to give some sense of confidence. I recognise, as you recognise, that there is a loss of consumer confidence in the country here. And the savings ratio of people in Ireland is very high at the moment. If you're going to restore any kind of confidence so that you can have job creation and opportunities created, of which there are many, it is important that the government provide an initiative in that regard, and that's where we're focused, including looking at the question of providing some assurance for credit in respect of business which wants to do business and where they can't get it at the moment. I'm quite sure that in your own capacity as a new deputy here, you will have had people from your constituency say to you that their overdrafts have been cut, that they can't get credit, and that despite the talk that goes on, there's very little of that actually going out there, and we need to be able to assure business with some degree of certainty that credit will be made available to them and can be made available to them, and that's going to happen now because of the decisions made in respect of the banking sector. So we're talking about a jobs initiative as distinct from what you call a jobs budget. And from that point of view, I hope that all those deputies who are responsible in part, well, most of you, for driving this economy and our country up onto the rocks, that you will support that initiative when it's published and when it's produced and when it's announced in the House here, as distinct from the carry-on that you people used to have in spending taxpayers' money with huge amounts of spin and all the rest of it. So from that perspective, this is a case of the government taking a lead in deliberately providing incentives to stimulate our own economy where jobs can be created, where opportunities can happen, and where people can have some sense of confidence that what we're about is giving them that hope that we've spoken of.
Thank you.
So in the context of the IMF-EU deal, which constrains our country, obviously the hand of cards that we've been left with is not as good as we would wish, but you have got to play them in the best order in which you decide in the interest of the people and the interest of the country, and that's
Thank
what
you
we
very
do.
Much.